Keegan with High Point Scientific, and part one in our series of the scale of the universe starts with our greatest source of energy, the nearest star to us, and our light, the sun. Putting into perspective such a massive and distant object can be quite difficult. The real size of the sun truly is unfathomable. First, let's try to understand the sheer magnitude of the sun and its place in our solar system. The rest of everything within the cosmos will be put into perspective in episodes 2, 3, and 4 using the speed of light. So, first thing is first, the sun spans about 865,370 miles across. That's 110 times the diameter of the Earth. Sunspots within the lowest layer of the atmosphere, called the photosphere, can be larger than the Earth itself. This is where we can find solar granules comparable to the size of Texas. There are large plasma jets from the chromosphere, which is the layer above the photosphere, that shoot away from the sun and can be nearly as large as the sun itself. The heliosphere, or the outermost layer of the sun's atmosphere, spans nearly 11.5 billion miles across. This distance is so great that it took Voyager 1 nearly 40 years to reach, traveling at a speed of 38,000 miles per hour. It takes light just 17 hours to make this journey. So to understand scale in our universe, we need to compare everything to the cosmic speed limit, or the speed of light. Light has a speed limit of about 670 million miles per hour. While this may seem incredibly fast, to us it's really quite slow in the grand scheme of things. You can find a pretty remarkable example if you look at the light emitted from the center of the sun, a 30 million degree ball of hydrogen soup, the core. The photons emitted from the core, they get stuck in the radiative zone, an incredibly dense layer within the sun. So dense, in fact, that photons simply cannot travel more than a short distance without smacking into matter and slowing down. It can take light made in the core of the sun nearly a million years to actually reach the photosphere and escape the surface where it travels to our own eyes. Now, all of this is pretty incredible. It would be pretty awesome if you could see this with your own eye. Are you really able to see plasma jets or sunspots or the Texas-sized granules on the surface of the sun? Absolutely.
There's several different types of filters available to all amateur astronomers, and they reveal different parts of the sun, the chromosphere, the photosphere, prominences, and sunspots.
A glass solar filter like this one from Spectrum Telescopes is going to show you the sun's photosphere in a brilliant orange tint where you can observe sunspots and granules on the photosphere. The Bader Astrosolar Film Filter, or white light filter, provides very crisp black and white views of these sunspots and granules. The chromosphere is where one can observe prominences and solar flares. Highly specialized solar scopes like the Lunt series will reveal fascinating and unforgettable views of the solar surface. There are even more exotic options, such as the calcium K filters, and these are going to offer vibrant purple views and reveal surface detail and sunspots. There are links in our description below to all of these products, as well as a link to our article which explains all of these solar concepts in much greater detail.
Now, it's dangerous to look at the sun without proper filters, but when properly installed, it allows us to see our nearest star in fantastic detail.
It's very simple to forget that the abundant energy produced by our sun can dictate all of life on Earth. Don't take for granted the sun. Light manufactured in the core of the sun makes its travels to its surface and then onwards towards our planet, where it supports nearly all of Earth's living organisms. It drives our weather patterns. It drives our seasons. It drives our climate and even our ocean currents. We are but a brief stop. Most of the light surpasses Earth and the other planets of the solar system and far beyond. So join us next week as we put into perspective the vastness and the scale of our own solar system through the speed of light. Again, I am Tegan with High Point Scientific, and I hope to see you there.